There is a massive church in Africa, in sub-Saharan Africa. It is growing so rapidly. And so there is a strong emphasis on the importance of establishing strong, faithful churches in every village in this country.
You find that our church in Uganda is growing steadily. If you set up a church in only 1 to 2 years, you'll find that you have to extend the church.
Most of the places in Uganda, even inside the slums, even in the villages, at least there are some churches. And which churches are there? They are very, very active. The Christians are there in the church. The gospel is being preached despite the challenges that we are meeting in Uganda.
And yet it is so full of bad teachings and false gospels.
I would like to see a church which is growing and truly not just to grow in numbers where people just come because they want to see miracles, they want to get this, and then they go like that. But I want to see a church which really believes in the Lord Jesus.
These days people, they are running too much to preach the gospel, the prosperity gospel, which is making a competition in preaching. And when there is a competition in preaching, that means most of the gospel is going to be tarnished, and people may run away from the truth.
The community, the society in Uganda is eager for the gospel, no doubt about that. But those that are supposed to give it, they are not well trained.
UMS is Uganda Martyrs Seminary, so it is a Church of Uganda Bible College just in the northeast of Kampala where we are now, training about 80 to 90 young men and women for gospel ministry all across Uganda and some in Kenya as well.
Yes, I've come to UMS because I want to be trained so that I can be a better minister of God.
To learn more, to be equipped with enough knowledge about the Word of God, because we want to teach the Word of God with knowledge when we know what we are teaching, but not to teach from out of the blue.
It is now expected that instead of closing our Bibles and preaching on some unrelated theme, we will open our passages, we will read it, we will get the main theme, we will try and apply it.
I used, I'm not ashamed to say this, I used to preach, just waking up, you open the passage, I think I should talk about this, and you preach, and you end up talking your words, and sometimes I found out that I used even to go away from the passage.
I can see the big picture, that it's about what Jesus came to do. He wants us to be forgiven for our sins.
Students aren't battling with lack of belief in one sense. There is an innate religiosity, spirituality in Uganda. Everyone believes in God. Everyone believes in afterlife. The question is, how? How do we know God? How can we live according to His will? And how can we reach heaven?
Spiritually, they are strong and they are really yearning to have the Word of God. We need more preachers to reach the people, because sometimes you find one person is running a parish which is having around 14 churches or 20 churches.
A lot of people in their villages who want to believe that if you become a Christian, your problems will be over in an instant. Of course you'll have lots of children, of course your cows will produce lots of milk, of course there won't be a famine in your area. And it's not a promise that our students can make, because it's not a promise that God makes. And so the divide between what they know is right to preach, the great glories of the gospel, but also what some people in their congregations or their parishes want to hear.
We have a number of churches that are having a lot of people, very many people, full of people, and they, because they preach prosperity gospel. Some churches, when they look at such preachers, they get attracted and they end up also preaching the same prosperity gospel, which is not good.
Who can go and help these people, uproot them out from the sins that they are living in, to give them some light about Jesus Christ, about God, so that they can feel the love that Jesus has for his people. And at the end of it all, they can come out of their sins and together we serve God. And therefore, I'm ready to move out any part of Uganda that God will allow me to go and preach the word of God.
There is a saying amongst many of the senior church leaders in here, in the church here, which is that you go out into ministry with a Bible in one hand and a hoe in the other. I see in our students this desperate desire to use every minute possible to preach the gospel and to take those opportunities. And yet at the same time, it's a direct trade-off. If you do that, you're going to struggle financially. Maybe you can't put your kids through school because you're not able to get perhaps a couple of extra jobs in the village or just work the land as much as you need to.
We have a God who cares for us. Amidst all trials, amidst all challenges, amidst all opposition to Christianity, we have a faithful God who stands with us. Let them continue in this spirit of serving the Lord. Greater things will come in these days, but most especially in eternity. Mm-hmm.